come to Tagore's shop. Why I am taking Tagore's leave? Because he find himself always in the web of God. Whatsoever he visualizes, outwardly or inwardly, or anybody who comes in contact with him, he visualizes God in them. This stage, though appears to be outwardly, that it is connected to inward. In general, he is talking of external things, but his inner self is awakened. But he is not sure of where to move, what to do, what not to do. That is the problem that I visualize in Tagore-ji. Guru Tagore, Dada Tagore. He says, I am taking the page 85, section 18. When the two sisters go to fetch water, he visualized two sisters in the morning walk perhaps. They came to the spot and they smiled. At a particular place, they used to wait for a second or fraction of a second, not in moving but in thoughts. Because that place was very prominent for them and that place was very prominent for Guru Tagore. They must be aware of somebody who stands behind the trees whenever they go to fetch water. That means they were moving towards the source of water, say, well. And in their path, this region of some trees was there. They had to cross that both ways, going and coming. So when they used to come to that very spot, they used to stay for a time, talk for a some time, smile and then used to move ahead. Tagore is watching this all and concentrating on it. That is why it is so. What is the reason behind it? The two sisters whispered to each other when they passed the spot. When they passed that very spot, that was very significant for them. And they definitely gave a signal to each other, oh, we have reached to this very spot. Sometimes while giving a small smile, sometimes to have a little stoppage, or one way or the other, they used to convey a message to each other at this very spot. I'll come to know to you what was the reason behind it. They must have guessed the secret of that somebody who stands behind the trees. Mostly, where there are trees, girls get some sort of fear, some sort of doubt that somebody might be standing there to watching them. But being two, they were least afraid of, least worried about, and so used to stay, move, come and go. They must have guess the secret at that somebody who stands behind them. They used to visualize perhaps somebody standing behind them. He's watching. He's not visible. He's invisible, but watching them both. Whenever we cross that very region, he watches us. This was visualized by Tagore. Whenever they go to fetch water, their pitchers lurch suddenly. That means some sort of agitation was there in their legs, and water also have a vibration in the pitchers. That means their legs were not moving properly. There was slight jerk in their legs and slight jerk in the pitcher and jerk in the water as well. Water also vibrated and perhaps somewhat may have fallen out of the pitcher. They must have found out that somebody's heart is beating who stands behind the trees. Naturally, if somebody is standing there, watching there, naturally his heart too will be beating. Because in the universe, nobody is talking about Surti. Everybody is talking of heart, mind, this and that. All the books are full of these things. Nobody knows what is Surti. So it is me who is talking of Surti and Surti only. Whenever they go to fetch water, that means no, he has come forward to say that somebody might be there. They were visualizing him and they were having some sort of fear in their mind that somebody may not be after them, watching them. What is his intention? What is his thoughts in his mind? They are not sure about that, but they were having some sort of fear in their behavior, in their attitude, in their thinking, in their mind. They must have found the two sisters glance at each other when they came to that spot and they smiled. They used to put eye to eye in their eyes and then smile was there on their face. They smiled and a glance on each other for that very spot. Dekha, somebody is watching us. Somebody is looking at us. You walked by the riverside path with the full picture upon your hip. I will stay up to this very stage. There is laughter in their swift stepping feet. They are at that very point, they are moving a bit fast. And when they are moving fast, stepping feet, swift step, they were moving fast at that very stage, which was behind their effort. They used to apply some force, extra force, while crossing that very spot. That means inwardly, they were having some sort of fear that somebody is watching them. Actually, this was the thought going on in the heart of Tagore himself. It was his imagination. It was his creation that he has put forth in these two girls, in their pictures, in the leaves of the trees, in that very stump. So this all is the imaginary idea of Rabindranath Tagore. Actually, what he wanted to convey, that we must realize that every place is full of what? There is not even a speck of dirt without him. Good or bad, whatsoever is there in this planet is very much present in them. We just saw he is present in Agni Tattva, he is present in water, he is present in air, he is present in earth, He is present in sky. He is present in all the elements. So naturally he is present in the leaves. He is present in the trees. So it was his presence that Tagore visualizes. He is not talking of some ghost, some evil spirit, this and that. He is talking of God. He, his own body, Shiva, when he says that the picture, the legs of those girls were shivering. He was inwardly himself shivering while writing this scene. This scene is created in his mind and he is penning it down on the page. So whatsoever lurks in our mind, we put it forth before the masses, and it lives for centuries together. And those who read this, they also go to that very stage and attain that very stage. Go to that very place, attain that stage. It is with every reader if he understands the language of the other. If he understands his frequency is well matched, rather I should say, when his frequency is well matched with the writer, he reaches there, he visualizes the same thing as Tagore felt. Because my frequency at this present is in resonance with the frequency of Tagore. That's why I am explaining the same idea, same thought which cropped up in the mind of Tagore. Rather, that idea in me is in purely Surti, because it is the Surti that contemplates, that concentrates, that vibrates, that infuses in others. So, my friends, my listeners, I respect you, I worship you, and at the same time say to you, please awaken your Surti. With your Surti, you can well discriminate. I can say that Tagore was not enlightened by any pure soul. He was moving in wilderness. He is crying in wilderness. He is grappling in wilderness. He wants to catch hold of God in his lap, but is moving in wilderness. He is everywhere, but not in a position to catch him. He is after him everywhere. In river, in shade, in trees, in mountains, in his books, everywhere he is visualizing God. But this visualization doesn't provide you frequency to see him. This is internal job. This has to be done internally. You have to move inwardly to attain the supreme secret of God, secret of Satpurush, secret of true Satguru. So please do concentrate, meditate, visualize, and think about yourself, your soul, and be in search of true and real Satguru in this universe, who can uphold you, uplift you, make you permanently free from the clutches of mind, who is always there to delude you, to put you in the corner, and never allow you to attain true path in your life. So with this, I stop my sermon to you people. So, Pyari Satsang Ji, Pyar Se Kahiye, Satguru Satnam Sat Sahib Ji, Satguru Satnam Sat Sahib Ji, Satguru Satnam Sat, Bol Satguru Dev Maharaj Ki Jai, Satguru Dev Maharaj Ki Jai, Satguru Dev Maharaj Ki Jai, Aaj Ke Satsang Ke Anand Ki Jai, Aaj Ke Satsang Ke Anand Ki Jai, Aaj Ke Satsang Ke Anand Ki Jai.